23 minutes past the top of the hour. So glad to have you with us. Hopefully you can hang out with us for a little while. We're going to open up the phone lines here shortly, but joining us live is Allie Tower. She's a follower of Jesus Christ now. But boy, I tell you what, she really quite literally went to the dark side. She's a former witch, and she's unpacking her story, and I so appreciate the fact that she's willing to do that. She's written a couple of books, Taken from the Night, and also From the Craft to Christ. And so as you walk through all of that, was it an uncomfortable process, and how long a process was it?
It was a couple years. It was a very uncomfortable process because I was still part of Wicca, and I was still practicing. And then I would go to church, and so it was kind of like being on the fence and back and forth. And, you know, I would take steps towards God and then take a step back. And, you know, it was really just a very stressful time spiritually. I felt torn, really. I felt a lot of, you know, torn, just like I was being torn in half. And it was a difficult time.
What about that defining moment when finally... that walk in the fence, walk in the line, straddling the fence, those days were over, and bam, God said, nope, this is it.
That was absolutely, like, wonderful. What had happened, actually, is, you know, after I had come back to church for a little while, I had gotten kicked out again and kind of went further even, you know, into the craft, and I just didn't want to hear anything about God at that point. I just completely shut him out of my life. And one day I had did a spell, because what happened was my pastor was kind of like a dad to me. He was like my father, and it seemed like he just was always like, you know, what he would had said to me over the years were just always gnawing at me when I was doing the things that I knew I shouldn't be doing. I kept thinking about something he would say, and it was really bothering me, and so I ended up doing what is called a banishing spell, just basically to cut the ties, and so that I wouldn't have to experience this anymore. And after doing it, I had waited about a month, and then I gave him a call. I just wanted to make sure that it worked. And when I called him up, he told me that he was actually retiring and he was going to be moving out of the area. And all of a sudden, it just, like, all came to me, and I was like, did I do this? Mm-hmm. And why would I want to do that? Why would I want someone who, you know, has spoken into my life and helped me in so many ways to be out of my life? And I felt really bad, and I told him what I had done. And I thought that was it. He would never speak to me ever again, because I knew that, you know, for him, this was really hurtful. And we hung up, and I just thought that was it. And then he called me back a couple days later, and he actually invited me to church, which was really bizarre.
Yeah.
And he said that there was this woman who was coming there who was part of the occult at one time, and he wanted her to talk with me. So I really didn't want to go. I had no desire at this point to go to church. But I went because I felt bad. Mm-hmm. And I figured, you know, when they finally said that I could come, it happened to be on Samhain. And so I was going to be out at a ritual for, you know, half the night. And the last place in the world I wanted to go to was church. But I felt bad. And so I did go. And while I was there, I walked in, and during praise and worship, and, you know, I think this is a really important thing to remember. During praise and worship, I just started crying, and I could not stop, and I didn't have reason in the world why I should be crying.
Yeah.
But it was just so overwhelming to me. And a lot of times I think, you know, that praise and worship is really where a lot of spiritual battles take place. And when we're praising God and he's there in our midst, it's just a really powerful time. I think sometimes we overlook that, but it's very important, because it's just kind of like all the walls around me just kind of dropped, and there I was. And they talked about, of course, about Halloween that day, and I was sat there very furious. A woman had come up and had taken my hand and told me that God had told her to come sit down and hold my hand, and that was probably a good thing because I probably would have left a whole lot sooner hadn't she done that.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I stayed there the whole time, and when they started to pray, and I said, this is it, I have to go, and I went to leave, then all of a sudden they introduced me to the woman that I was supposed to meet, and we sat down and talked, and before I knew it, church had stopped, and everybody had went home, and I found myself kind of barricaded in this little enclosure with these praying warriors. And I was just like, okay, this is enough. Thank you for praying, but I'm out of here. And I actually ran out the building and got outside and realized I had forgot my purse. So I had to go back in to get it. And when I went back in, the pastor just simply said, you can't run from God.
Yeah.
And that was it. I just stopped because I knew that he was right. And no matter where I went, no matter what I did, he would always be there with me. And the realization that, wow, God is with me,
mm-hmm.
you know, came to me. And on that day, which I had no way of knowing ahead of time that that would ever happen, but it was on Halloween that I gave my life back to the Lord.
Oh, my goodness. The way God set everything up. You could never plan something like this. It's just so powerful.